Hello everyone, last time I asked you how many different ways are there to completely fill a noughts and crosses grid using 4 noughts and 5 crosses, not including rotations and reflections of the board. Now I can tell you that the answer is 23. There are 23 different ways to completely fill a noughts and crosses grid. There are a couple of ways to solve this. One is kind of a brute force way. The other is more of a mathematician's way, which is how I did it. We're going to have a look at both of them. So before we start worrying about rotations and reflections, let's just ask, how many ways can we fill our 3x3 grid using 4 noughts and 5 crosses? Well, you've got 9 positions and 9 objects. So you're going to fill the first position with a choice of 9 objects. You fill the second position with a choice of 8 objects. The third position you fill with 7 objects left. And you multiply your choices together. So you're going to get 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. That's called 9 factorial. I'm doing that very quickly because I have talked about that sort of thing before. However, we have overcounted here. You see, we can interchange the noughts without changing the grid. So those 4 noughts can swap around. How many ways can I swap those 4 noughts around? 4 factorial ways to do that. So we divide through by 4 factorial. We can also interchange the 5 crosses between themselves. And there's 5 factorial ways to do that. So again, we divide by a further 5 factorial. So we get the answer 126. There's 126 grids. But that does include rotations and reflections. So now we're going to reduce that number further. If you take a grid, there are 8 ways you can hit it with rotations and reflections. That's 4 rotations, you've got a quarter turn, a half turn, 3 quarter turns, and then there's the do nothing rotation. And there's 4 reflections. Reflect it in the horizontal axis, the vertical axis, and the 2 diagonals. Now, if every grid produced 8 different grids when you hit it with rotations and reflections, then what we could do is take that 126 number and divide by 8. Unfortunately, it's not that easy. Some grids do produce 8 different rotations and reflections. Some grids only produce 4 different rotations and reflections. And some grids only produce 1 rotation reflection. And when I say 1, I just mean the original grid itself. Now, all the grids you get after you hit a grid with rotations and reflections, all the different grids you get is called the orbit for that grid. Now, if we take all the different orbits and take all the grids in those orbits and add them together, we should get 126 different grids. If we take one grid from each orbit, then we should get all the essentially different grids. So not including rotations and reflections. Now, if we do that, you should find, and it's just a bit of checking, I'm afraid, you should find 23 different orbits. 10 orbits have size 8. You get 8 different grids when you hit them with rotations and reflections. 11 orbits have size 4, and 2 orbits have size 1 each. And altogether, that adds up to 126 grids. So that is a bit laborious. That's your answer, 23 orbits. But let's take a look at the mathematician's way. So rotations, reflections, and orbits, this is all part of something called group theory. Group theory is the mathematics of symmetry. Now, I used the result from group theory to solve this problem. I used something called Burnside's Lemma. Now, to use this lemma, you need to know how many grids are fixed for each rotation and each reflection. When I say fixed, I mean when you hit it with a rotation or a reflection, the grid is unaffected. It looks the same. So if I take the do nothing rotation, then that leaves all grids, 126 grids, the same, unaffected. If I take a quarter turn, if it's going to be unaffected and look the same, that means all the corners are going to have to be the same. All the corners, when I turn it a quarter turn, I've cycled through. So all the corners will need to be the same. And there's only 2 ways you can do that. So for a quarter turn, there are only 2 grids that remain unaffected. It's the same for a three-quarter turn. A half turn is more interesting. If you take a grid and do a half turn, how many grids remain fixed, unaffected? In that case, the diagonal corners will need to be the same. The opposite sides will need to be the same. And don't forget, we're only using four noughts here, four noughts, five crosses. And under those conditions, you can work out that there are six grids that remain unaffected by a half turn. You can go through a similar sort of thinking for reflections as well. For a reflection, either side of the reflection will have to look the same. And if you do that, you'll find there are 12 grids that remain unaffected for each reflection. Now, Burnside's lemma says that the number of orbits, and that's the answer we want, the number of orbits is equal to the average number of fixed grids. So how many fixed grids do we have? Well, we add these together, 126 for the do-nothing. We had two grids fixed for the quarter turn, two grids fixed for a three-quarter turn, six were fixed for a half turn, and 12 for each reflection. We'll add those together, but this is an average number we need, so I'm going to divide by 8 as well, because there's 8 rotations and reflections, and you get the final answer. You get 23. There are 23 orbits, and I have the final answer, and I don't have to draw it out. Now, that's not obvious, but first thing, that is not obvious. I didn't expect you to know Burnside's lemma. That is something you'll meet probably in the first year of a maths degree at university, but I thought it'd be a good excuse to show you Burnside's lemma. The important thing is I didn't have to draw them out. I did know there were 23 essentially different grids. When I did try and draw them out, I found 22 and I couldn't find the last one. I was going, I know there is 23. I know I'm missing one, but it was really hard. I couldn't find this last one, but I did know that there had to be 23 of them. And, well, there you have it. And as usual, if you have been, thanks for watching.